Hi, part-time time travelers, Jake here, and welcome to a video that I've been waiting to make for a very long time. Now, in 2003, six-year-old me was gifted a beautiful VHS tape, The Cat in the Hat. I put on this graceful movie and fell totally in love with it.
Honey, it was ruined when she bought it. Yeah.
I watched it for 2 weeks straight. I would say it was one of my first hyper-fixations. I loved this movie so much. I loved the colors inside of it. I loved Mike Myers as the cat. I loved how fast-paced it was. Something about this movie just stuck with me. Throughout the years, I appreciated it even more as I got to know more of the adult jokes.
He never used a litter box. He made a mess in the house. That's why they sent him to a vet to cut off both his balls.
And just how absurd this movie is.
Jim McFlanagan!
Mr. Homage,
I wanted to thank you.
Fired.
I beg your pardon?
Fired.
But I...
Of course, I found online that this movie isn't that well liked, and one day found that it was terribly reviewed. Of course, I was livid. I was gonna defend this movie till the end, and then I went to film school. And realized, yeah, it's pretty bad. But it didn't stop me from whenever I had my friends over and we would share a few drinks, that I would slip the VHS tape in and we would watch The Cat in the Hat. And oh boy, would we laugh. It may be bad, but it is so bad it is good. And I came to appreciate a movie does not have to be good for it to be enjoyable. I still am so attached to this movie. And today, for this video, you're gonna see what The Cat in the Hat does to a six-year-old brain 20 years later. So I saw back in November that it was the 20th anniversary to The Cat in the Hat, and I wanted to make a video homaging this movie. So I invited my friend Rosie. Rosie was also born in 1997 and loved this film. I think it started to be a correlation. Anyone born around 1997 has some sort of attachment to this movie just by the time it came out. You know what? Watching it now, it has a lot of Gen Z humor to it. I think that it was the creator of this type of humor, or maybe it was just ahead of its time. I don't know, but a lot of people around my age liked this movie unironically. Rosie and I decided to get together and make a video recreating some scenes and transforming myself into the cat, and it was a total disaster. Some of the scene recreations did not work, some of our equipment failed, just like the movie. This video is a total disaster, but I wanted to put it together for you and have you enjoy the movie as much as Rosie and I did. Now, there's going to be a lot of references to the movie in this video, so be prepared. If you have not seen the movie, well, just go ahead and watch this video and be totally confused. But if you are a Cat in the Hat fan, I want you to enjoy the 20 years of joy and laughter this movie has made through our video honoring such a masterful piece of art. So to start our journey today, I'm gonna show you when Rosie first arrived and we got together to transform myself into the Cat in the Hat. My lifelong 20-year dream to become the cat is finally here. Please enjoy.
All right.
Hello.
Hi.
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 We just watched our favorite movie.
Because it's the 20th anniversary of the lovely, the wonderful Cat in the Hat.
Oh yeah!
I don't know if you guys can see beside me, but I've got a lot of makeup stuff, and I'm dressed up.
I am going to be dressed
He's
up.
He's almost dressed up, so I'm going to complete his costume. I'm going to turn him into the Cat in the Hat. Oh my god, your hat is very flat.
This is me seeing Joan Walden. Awkward. Awkward. It's getting better all the time. I used to get mad at my school. The teachers who taught me weren't cool. You're holding me down, turning me around, filling me up with your rules. I got you in me, it's getting better.
Freak
you out for a second?
It was creepy. Like a really... It was gross. this stuff just doesn't stick on your knees. Being an angry young man, me hiding my head in the sand. You gave me the word. Short commercial break. His face is
back to normal. It's pretty
not,
much.
Except for the nose. The nose worked out, the little puffballs didn't, so filter floss.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stick it on his face.
This is safe.
This is...
Don't try it at home.
Don't take our word for it, but...
Yeah. And it's important to know that, failure happens. Even in tutorial... This isn't a tutorial. But failure happens.
Yes.
When you do makeup or anything like
everything
that.
Everything and anything in life, you're gonna fail at it.
Anything?
Anything.
Anything?
Yes, anything.
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 There's my hat. Meow.
Oh my god.
Wait, I need to grab my gloves. Give me five. Oh yeah! I know that it's wet and the sun is not sunny, but we can have lots of good fun that is funny. It's fun to have fun, but you got to know how. I know lots of good tricks, and I...
Stop this right now!
Huh?
Well, are you enjoying the video yet? So, one of the ideas that Rosie and I had was, what would the cat be doing in the year 2023, 20 years after the movie? We both came to the consensus that he would be doing a podcast. We, filmed for a whole hour, and our improv was just not working. Until Rosie had the brilliant idea, let's parody the style of the controversial Joe Rogan. This video does not endorse Joe Rogan in any way. In fact, we're kind of making fun of him a little bit here. So, Thing One has a podcast, The Thing Experience, and they are interviewing the Cat in the Hat. Enjoy.
So you've been to the human world,
you said. The human world, yeah.
What was that like?
It is nothing like you could ever imagine.
Yeah.
Everything there is constantly moving. People are mad at each other. The kids, don't get me started on the kids.
The kids?
The kids, they're
awful.
What's
wrong with the kids?
They hung me in a tree and beat me with a bat.
What?
Hit me right where I got neutered. Like, you know what I'm saying?
No way.
What were the kids' names? Sally and Concrete. We were running away. We were trying to get the dog. I visited these kids because they needed to pick me up.
Did you bone their mom?
No, but the neighbor, he looked like that actor that's accused of manslaughter right now.
Alec Baldwin.
Yeah, he looked like Alec Baldwin, yeah.
Yeah.
Lawrence was his name.
Okay, and Lawrence, what a douchey name.
He wanted the kid to go to military school. Yeah, so I was just, having fun with the kids. We signed the contract. Everyone knows about my contracts.
Yep, I had to sign one to get him on the show.
My lawyers are just around the corner. Just watch what you say, alright? So, yeah, we went out. And we were searching for their dog, because their stupid dog escaped.
Oh.
Am I allowed to say dog on this show?
I say dog all the time.
See, I have a problem with the word dog, so I don't use the D word per se.
I don't give a shit.
So I mentioned at the start of the video that we had some failed green screening attempts. In this one, we wanted to lip sync a scene in the film of the cat introducing the things because it is just so funny. And we had a lot of fun filming this. We did it in front of the green screen so that we can get two of Rosie and me and put me in the background of the cat's house. Overall, the lighting just wasn't it. And for some reason, the actual audio of the movie could not sync up with what we did. It kept messing up, so enjoy some beautiful camera audio and this whole little disaster right here. Oh my god.
Ah, yes, of course. Think 2 would like to clarify that just because he wears the number 2 does not imply in any way that he's inferior to Thing 1.
I don't give up.
He says you may feel free to call him Thing A if you like. He will also accept Super Thing, Thing King, Kid Dynamite, Chocolate Thunder, or Ben.
Little Thing.
Little me.
Little Thing.
So their dog escaped. And we were searching for the dog, and we went to this birthday party. Because the dog ran because there was a whole bunch of meat on the table.
There were wieners.
Oh, there was... It was weird. There was no one outside. And there was just this food sitting there. It was all hot dogs. The kids all ran out. And Sally and Condor got ahead of me. And when they got ahead of me, I couldn't catch up in time for the kids to see me. Because, you know, I'm a 6-foot talking cat.
Yeah. You know? I can't imagine... Like, how did you disguise yourself in the world? Like, did you get noticed?
Well... I'm sure I got noticed, but in the human world, I guess they just let stuff like this get by. I don't know, this was back when Michael Jackson was still alive, alright? So, I don't know what they thought those kids were traveling with me for, but we got away with it.
Now, a lot of people ask me, who is my favorite character in this film? And that's a very easy question to answer. In 2003, I'm looking up to the TV screen, watching this movie for the first time, and I fell in love. I fell in love with a babysitter, and her name was Mrs. Kwan.
Hi, Mrs. Kwan.
Hi.
So to the musical stylings of the new Beatles song, here's a homage to the lady that babysat when no one else would.
You could do no
people thing.
I'm not even sure what state I was in. I just kind of appeared. I assume it was Ohio.
Ohio.
It gave me Ohio vibes.
Yeah.
So I was there, and...
This is off topic. Have you ever seen a Rhode Island license
plate? I have never seen a Rhode Island license plate.
Me neither.
You never see those.
You never see them.
Oh, my look.
I've never seen one. I'm convinced that the Rhode Island
state is... I saw one that day. I was in the human world.
No shit.
We were driving along. I let the kids drive. Not a good, on my part, looking back, not a good idea.
Well, how old are the kids?
Sally had to be 8, and Concrete had to be 10.
And you let them drive.
Probably not my greatest idea. I also pulled the brakes, but it's a whole different story.
Yeah.
So we were driving this slow, and I let Concrete drive, and he goes down a freaking wrong-way street.
Really?
Like, this
idiot.
Well,
you let a fucking 10-year-old drive.
Well, he's the one that stole the lock off my crate.
So wait, our world seeped out into theirs?
Yes.
What the fuck, dude?
Yeah, I put the crate there. Of course, I had to get the things out.
Yeah.
We let them out. I put the lock on, and this fucking kid breaks open the lock. So you know what we had to do to make sure that it didn't seep out into the world?
What?
We had to put the babysitter.
Wait a minute. What is that?
Okay, so you know baby levers?
Yeah.
This is the opposite of that.
They sit on them.
Yes.
What?
I know, and they get paid for it.
What?
Yeah, I don't know. I'd do it for nothing.
Fuck. Me too.
So to prove to you all of how much I love this movie, this isn't so much a scene recreation, but by heart, I am going to say the lines of my favorite scene in this film as it plays. I hope I can get it. Okay, and...
Excuse me, sir. I'd like you to sign my petition. Yeah.
Get out of my way, you hippie freak.
Are you aware of the senseless wholesale slaughter the flatulating acid spittings in Zimmeru? Yeah.
What will it take to get you out of my face?
Just sign my petition with this large, oversized pen that requires two hands.
I see. You hold my dog?
Okay, I have a problem with the word dog. I don't use the D word per se, because I think it's really, really wrong. Yeah. But I'll happily hold your canine American. Yeah. I'm more comfortable with that.
How much is a canine American in the window?
It's me.
So, we have the babysitter on the crate. We're chasing the canine American down the street.
Yeah.
And out of nowhere, we get involved in this birthday party. Long story short, they have a piñata. I was hanging where the piñata once stood.
Okay. How'd you get there?
Magical time-traveling elves. They hung me and were spinning me around, and they all started beating me at once.
Oh my god.
Until the kid came up with a baseball bat. And he whacked me in the gonads.
What the fuck?
And
he's a little psycho. I'd kick the shit out of him if I were you.
You know, it was almost euphoric. When he hit me there, I blacked out. And I was on a swing.
Wow.
And there was a horse behind me. And that song, Easy Like a Sunday Morning. Yeah,
love
you
that
know,
song.
Love that song.
Great song.
Great song. It was playing in my head for about 5 seconds.
Wow.
I thought I died.
You had an out-of-body experience,
it was,
man.
I was also wearing a bonnet and shit. It was... I don't understand it. The human world does weird things to you.
I've heard that they have some crazy substances over there.
Well, that Lawrence I was talking about, he had to be on something, I tell you.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so... finally, Coat Rack released the candy. So we were able to escape. I almost beat one of the kids myself, but I can't have another felony.
The one that hit you in the nads?
Yeah, yeah. I was going to hit him.
I would have killed that kid.
Yeah, but I want my chance to return to that world, you know? Okay. I'm all about helping these poor, helpless little shits. We're so excited! So for the end of our 20th anniversary video, we really wanted to create the cupcakes that you see in the film.
So today, I'm going to be showing you how to make a Russian dressing. And you're gonna heat your oven.
Yeah, we should probably do that.
While the oven's heating up.
While the conventional oven is heating up.
All I'm a professional.
Yo, do we have oven mitts?
That's a good question. Do you want to make this purple?
Yes, I can make it purple.
Blue and I make purple.
Which colors?
Don't ask me again.
Blue and green?
No.
Betty Crocker, candidate's number one. If you guys don't know how to make cupcakes, it's on the back of the box.
Cupcakes? Oh yeah!
So it's just oil, water, eggs. Third of a cup of oil. You might wanna use the knife. Crack your eggs, don't get shell. Look at that. Bro, it won't come out.
Why is the egg doing that?
This is awful. This is the worst.
Just gonna get a little messy. We will clean up after. Looks great.
Oh yeah!
Can you get it perfect? Look at her go!
Oven's done.
Hi, it's been a little bit. I hope you're liking the video. So before we finish off the video showing you the big reveal of what our beautiful cupcakes looked like, we thought that we would, of course, recreate the most brilliant scene in the whole movie, the kitchen infomercial scene. Now I will say this was another one of our disasters of the video shoot, as we didn't record audio for half of it, and it just is awkward. So I mixed in some clips with the movie to help us go along, and hopefully you don't notice the difference. I don't know, just laugh at our failures. Enjoy!
Hello, hello everybody! Welcome to Astounding Products! I'm your host, the guy in the sweater that asks all the obvious questions. Now here with us today to show his astounding product, all the way from Cheshire, England.
It's me! Me! Hartwell! I'm so excited!
Do you love making cupcakes but hate all the hard cupcake work? I know I do. Don't forget everything you know about making cupcakes and say hello to the amazing Cupcakeinator. I'm so excited!
Cupcake a what?
Cupcakeinator!
This amazing device can help make cupcakes out of anything in the kitchen.
Hold on a minute. Did you say anything?
Yes, anything.
Anything?
Yeah, anything.
Anything?
Yes, anything.
Anything?
I'll get you, and it'll look like a bloody accident. Yes, anything. How about, I don't know, a condom and...
What?
A pack of hot dogs. A bottle of ketchup. And I know what you're thinking. Even a fire extinguisher.
Now, close the lid and Bob's your flippin' uncle. What an astounding product! Oh yeah! Open the drawer. Fill the patented cupcake in it to tray. Close the drawer. Then plate it in a conventional oven. Delicious cupcakes are just minutes away.
Did you just say minutes away?
That's
impossible.
You're not just wrong, you're stupid.
Now wait just a minute.
And ugly, just like your mom.
Did you just call my mother ugly?
Shut up, I mean it. I will end you.
Cat, your tail.
What about it? Oh, I see. I've chopped it off. Well, that's funny because... Son of a bitch!
And now for what you've been waiting for. To cap off the 20th anniversary video of The Cat in the Hat and to honor 20 years of one of the most brilliant bad movies in the world. You know what? I'm not even going to say it's bad. This movie is good. To cap off a great movie, cap off the anniversary of a fantastic movie. How did Rosie and I's cupcakes look. Just like the movie, I hope. Cheers to 20 years of The Cat in the Hat. It's been a ride. One of my favorite movies. Joan Walden's cookies. Joan Walden's muffins.
Cupcakes.
Joan Walden's... Joan Walden's muffins.
Cupcakes.
Fuck! Joan Walden's cupcakes. Made out of anything.
Did you say anything?
Anything.
Anything.
Yeah, anything.
Oh my god. Are they good?
Uh-huh.
Holy fuck, gross.
Thanks for watching!